Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages. Amen.
My enemies are made stronger than I, and they that hate me unjustly
For in this I shall no man living be justified, for
For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, and he hath humbled my life down to the earth. Yet sat me in darkness as though the past had been long dead, and my spirit within me is become as one. Within me my heart is troubled. I remember days of old, and meditated on all my works, I pondered on the creations of thy hand. I stretched forth my hand unto thee. My soul thirsteth after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord. My spirit hath fainted away. Turn not thy face away from me, lest I be like them that go down into the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for in thee have I put my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for unto thee have I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, to thee have I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness for thy name's sake. O Lord, shall thou quicken me. In thy righteousness shall thou bring my soul out of affliction, and thy mercy shall thou intervene from my enemies. For thou shalt cut off all of them that afflict my soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and the wages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. O our God and our hope, glory to thee.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, for the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for those who with faith, reverence, and fear of God enter therein, for our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For the President of the United States and also authorities and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Bonnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Anna, and Skyler, let us pray to the Lord. For Metropolitan Archbishop John and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord. For this city and for every city and land and for the faithful who dwell therein, for health, for seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, for those under persecution, for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed, most glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our life unto Christ our God.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
God is the Lord who save us, have mercy upon us, keep us, O God, by thy grace. All in your remembrance are all holy and immaculate, most blessed and glorious, the Theotokos, never Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto you, Christ our God.
For thine is the majesty, and thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Let us get our
Christ our God.
For blessed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Seek the living among the dead. He is not here, but is risen. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee that the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified, and on the third day rise again. And they remembered his words, and returning from the tomb, they told all this to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene and Joanna, and Mary the mother of James, and the other women with them who told this to the apostles. But these words seemed to them idle tales, and they did not believe them. But Peter rose and ran to the tomb, stooping and looking in. He saw the linen cloths by themselves, and he departed, wondering at what had happened.
Great Gregory, the theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril, and John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spirit of Trimethus, and Nectarius of Pentapolis, the wonder workers of our fathers among the saints, Deacon, Patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius the Merce Reaper, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Venus the Wonder Worker, of the Hierophantus, Ignatius, the God Bearer of Antioch, Aranamos and Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women and martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kyriaki, Botini, Marina, Paris, Eva, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, bright, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim, of the holy prophet, Zephaniah, Martyrs, Agapios, Shilepkos, and Mamas, Venerable Theodulos, Eparch of Constantinople, Hieromartyr Gabriel, Bishop of Gamos and Prusa, New Martyr and Angelis of Chios, and Venerable Cosmos of St. Anne's Peak on Athos, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
Seleucus and Mamas, Venerable Theodulos, Epark of Constantinople, Eric Martyr, Martyr Gabriel, Bishop of Gonos and Prusa, New Martyr Angeles of Chios, and Venerable Cosmos of St. Augustine and Athos. By their intercession, O Christ our God, have mercy on us. Amen.
Thank you.
Christ our God.
Oh.
for the salvation of our souls, for the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who with faith, reverence, and fear of God enter therein, for our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for the clergy of the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States and all civil authorities and for our armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Adam, and Skyler, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution, for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us so brought by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed, and glorious names of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our life unto Christ our God.
Save
upon us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious, with the of Jesus Christ, all of the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Amen.
us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy art thou, our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever.
And unto ages of ages.
But when anything is exposed by the light, it becomes visible, for anything that becomes visible is light. Therefore it is said, "Awake, O sleeper, and arise from the dead, and Christ will give you light." Look carefully then how you walk, not as unwise men, but as wise, making the most of the time, because the days are evil. Therefore do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. And do not get drunk with wine, but with for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with all your heart.
Peace be to thee, that read it.
Thy Spirit.
Let us
to St. Luke. Jesus drew near to Jericho, a blind man was sitting by the roadside begging, and hearing a multitude going by, he inquired what this meant. They told him, "Jesus of Nazareth is passing by." And he cried, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." And those who were in front rebuked him, telling him to be silent. But he cried out all the more, "Son of David, have mercy on me." And Jesus stopped and commanded him to be brought to him. And when he came near, Jesus asked him, "What do you want me to do for you?" He said, "Lord, let me receive my sight." And Jesus said to him, "Receive your sight. Your faith has made you well." And immediately he received his sight and followed Jesus, glorifying God. And all the people, when they saw it, gave praise to God.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to thee, O Lord.
Are the questions here? Oh yeah, there they are. I can remember a time a few years back where it was impossible to get lost in the crowd in St. Barnabas. We've grown a little bit since then. Time for another churching.
Praise the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, God Almighty, the Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, who by thy word hast
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, of God. Well, kind of like the prayer we just did, asking, since God has granted this child the physical life, that he would grant him the spiritual life in due time. So our gospel lesson, actually both of our scripture lessons, the gospel and the epistle, both speak of light in one form or another. In the gospel, of course, we heard of the blind man who, by his repeated entreaties, received his sight, the physical light, but he also received the spiritual light in recognizing Christ and following him, glorifying God, as Luke tells us. It is of interest, I think, to us as Orthodox that the blind man used an early form of the Jesus prayer, you notice, crying out, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. Of course, that term, Son of David, was a messianic term. It means that the blind man recognized in Jesus that he was the one called, promised by God to deliver Israel. And notice that he kept crying out this prayer repeatedly, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. Despite the rebukes of those who were around him, the crowd told him, shut up, you know, stop pestering the Lord like they really care about the Lord. But they just didn't want to listen to him, I suppose. And of course, the same is true whenever we try to pray to God. There are so many forces, if you will, that try to silence us and tell us to shut up. The demons rebuke us and try to discourage our prayer. And oh, how easily they do it. Because we are all too willing to just sort of give in. Say, yeah, I didn't want to pray anyway. Our own lack of faith is many times to blame. Distractions, inattentiveness, boredom, can hit the mute button on our prayers. We need to take a lesson from this man who got his healing. Why? Because he persisted. He kept crying out. And when they told him to shut up, like any good three-year-old, he just got louder. So, there you go. We need to pray, and we need to be persistent. And we need to pray our way through every obstacle, every bad feeling, every thought, every temptation, every distraction, every idea that, oh, God's not listening anyway. Don't bother the master now. Pray your way through it until that thing just explodes. Our Lord, our epistle lesson also speaks today of yet another kind of light, the light of truth. St. Paul tells us to walk as children of the light, the fruit of which is found in all that is good and right and true. To this he adds one more thing, telling us, try to learn what is pleasing to the Lord. Well, we'll talk about that in a moment. But first, what does it mean to walk in the light? I heard one person describe it as not keeping secrets from God. You know, that was pretty good. I mean, we know, of course, you can't keep secrets from God who sees all, knows all. And God even sees the things that we don't normally see, the hidden motivations of our hearts, the passions that we might not yet even be aware that we have, of the real reasons behind what we think and say and do in all things. We don't often pay attention. We may not know, but God sees, God knows. Part of our work as Christians is to boldly take this spiritual light, this light of truth, into those dark corners of our souls and expose what lurks in darkness, bringing it to the cleansing light of, let's say, the confessional, where we learn to tell the truth about ourselves and discover, you know, the uncomfortable reality that we're not as wonderful as we'd like to believe in all things. Interestingly enough, we are far more wonderful than we think we are in other ways. But only when we discover the light of God does that come clear. But even knowing that God sees all things, people still try to keep secrets. We all do, in fact. We are, or at least we act as if we could, you know? If we don't admit to ourselves our wicked little thoughts, our fantasies, our judgments of others, which are not given from God, you know, the vile things that happen when we are alone with our computer, seen by God. The eye that lingers a little too long, the ear that listens, the heart that desires wrongly become blemishes on the soul that God sees. And so walking in the light, you know, not keeping secrets from God, is defined as living in a way that will not leave us exposed and ashamed on that day when all secrets will be revealed. We discussed this with the catechism class a week or two ago about the books that will be open on Judgment Day. God doesn't really keep books. Those books are your soul. When God exposes and opens your soul, all the marks on it will be seen, everything, the good and the bad. So we do nothing in secret because it will be exposed. And we realize I need to live for that day. You know, what, I don't want to be ashamed in that hour. Try to learn what is pleasing to the Lord, Paul says. I think we ought to make a little sign like this for our prayer corner. Put it in there. And every morning when you do your prayers, do not leave before you read your little sign that says, try to learn what is pleasing to the Lord. And go out and try to live that way. Because you know, if you don't seek actively to try to please God every day in your thoughts, your words, your desires, then who is left to please? Who are you going to please if you're not pleasing God? Yourself, I guess. By default, we do serve our own pleasure. And thus St. Paul warns, be careful how you walk, brethren. Not as unwise men, but as wise, making the most of the time, for the days are evil. When we just go out and live life without a thought, we are acting like fools. Life is not neutral, you know. Every moment we need to be mindful of God, lest our lives be wasted in vanity. And here's another little question to consider when we're thinking about trying to learn what is pleasing to God. To whom does your life belong, anyway? You know, we're so used to the culture saying, my life is mine, you know, but go parasailing or something, you know. We have to go out and live life, bull riding, there you go. You know, your life does not belong to you when you get on the back of that bull, I can tell you what. But, of course, your life doesn't belong to you. It's on loan to you. You are the steward of your life. I mean, it's not yours. You didn't make it. Did you create your own life? Did you decide where you were, what country you would live, what time you would live, what color your eyes would be, how many eyes you would have? If your life did belong to you, then there would be no judgment awaiting you at the end. You see, the judgment is proof that your life is not yours. It is on loan to you. You are responsible, and you will give an account to the giver of life for how you use that life. Your life is on temporary loan from God for a purpose, and that purpose is magnificent. The purpose of your life is to share His grace and His love with the world, and to make this life better for everyone and for the life to come as well. If you only live for yourself, then darkness and the evil of this world will overtake you. That's why Paul said, walk carefully, for the days are evil. They're not neutral. They will swallow you up unless you're living for God. And so, we must walk in the light as children of the light. We must always free ourselves from every impurity of soul and body. Let the light of God shine in us, and through us to all the world. Seeking the light, let us become the light, the glory of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, keep us, O God, by thy grace, wisdom.
Ages.
his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages. Amen.
And all civil authorities, and are our forces everywhere. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
For the Orthodox servants of God, especially for the Archpriest Wayne and his family, for Kevin, Pauline, and their family, for Dane, Yvonne, Sean, Drew, and Nadia, for the Korea Diane, for Craig, for Aubrey, Maggie, Mary, Stacy, Sophia, Christina, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sins. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for the newly departed Korea Lynn, for Helen, for Christian, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Guide your souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. ask it for the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord.
Thou and thine only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit.
out of blessed goodness, bring us from non-existence into being. And when we have fallen away, disgrace us up again. And does not cease to do all things until thou hast brought us back to heaven and hast endowed us with thy kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee and to thine only begotten Son and our Holy Spirit. For all things of which we know not, and which we know and know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry which thou hast vouchsafed to receive in our hands, even though there stand beside thee thousands of archangels and thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six great many-eyed sword aloft borne on their hands, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
thank you.
reside and those who in faith dwell therein. Be mindful, O Lord, of those who travel by sea, by land, and by air, of the sick, the suffering, captives, and their salvation. Be mindful, O Lord, of those who bear fruit and do good works in thy holy churches, and who remember the poor, and upon us all, send forth thy mercy. Grant us with one mouth and one heart to glorify and praise, and all honorable and majestic name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all.
Thank you. God's church, the communion is reserved for those who are Eastern Orthodox. For those who are with us today visiting, we welcome you and invite you at the end of the service to partake of the blessed bread, the antimony. That would be over on either side of the altar. If you find that you're interested in the Eastern Orthodox Church and like to learn more about it, I invite you to join in the classes that exist after the services every Sunday. I invite all of you to come now forward who are prepared for the body of Lord Jesus Christ to do so.
With the fear of God and faith and love, draw near.
Thank you.
precious and holy body of the Lord, Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, who is going to be mission of sins and for life everlasting.
God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Thank you.
day, defeat us with thy endless and mortal mysteries. Make straight our path, establish all of us in thy fear. Guard our life, make firm our steps. Through the prayers and intercessions of the glorious Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, and of all thy saints. Our Lord, sanctification, and unto thee we ascribe glory. Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Sanctifies those who put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. Glorify them and recompense by thy divine power. And forsake us not who hope on thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, to all civil authorities, to our armed forces, and to all thy people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, cometh down from thee, the Father of lights. Unto thee we ascribe glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
The mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, the remission of our sins. Let us ask of Christ our immortal King and our God.
Forerunner and Baptist John, of the Holy Glorious and All Honorable Apostles,
of our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of St. Barnabas, patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God Joachim and Anna, of the holy prophet Zephaniah, the martyrs Agapios, Seleukios, Mamas, the venerable Theodulus, Eparch of Constantinople, and the hieromartyr Gabriel, bishop of Gannos and Prusa, the new martyr Angelus of Chios, and the venerable Cosmas of the St. Anne's Kingdom on Athos, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and love us mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.